Hello, I'm Brandon Leonard, Director of Strategic Initiatives with Men's Health Network, and I'm here at the Veterans and Sexual Health Dialogue Meeting. And today I'm joined by Dr. Ingrid Herrera-Yee, who is Manager for Military and Veterans Policy and Support at the National Alliance for Mental Illness, or NAMI. Dr. Herrera-Yee, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
If you could start out by telling us a little bit about your organization, NAMI, what you all do and what you personally do in your work on supporting veterans and sexual health issues.
Okay. The National Alliance on Mental Illness, we really support the families as well as the service member or veteran or even civilians, of course, who suffer with mental illness. And so my role as the military and veteran policy and support person at NAMI, basically we are looking at issues that affect the mental health and well-being of our military service members, our veterans, and their families. And so a piece of that would be the sexual health of our service members, veterans, and family members as well.
Okay, great. So you are a military spouse. Can you tell me a little bit about your experience and how you feel these issues that we're talking about today impact family members and particularly partners of veterans who are dealing with sexual health issues?
Sure. As with a lot of mental health issues, there's a stigma associated with talking about these issues. So oftentimes they're felt in the family because it's not addressed outside. And so, you know, as a spouse or a partner, when you see that your spouse or partner is withdrawn or depressed and you don't know why, you know, it could be really detrimental to the cohesion, you know, to the relationship. And so I feel that the stigma around it is huge, and we really need to increase communication between partners, spouses, the service member or veteran with their spouse, but also to help the relationship with a physician, for example, to really allow the service member to feel comfortable to talk about these types of issues. The way I always equate it is, you know, if you have something like diabetes and your you know, blood sugar is high, you're going to go get help. You're going to speak to your doctor and get insulin or whatever it is that you know, change your diet, do whatever it is that you need to do to help with that. I think that if we viewed sexual health in the same way, it could go a long way. If you're having issues in your relationship and you're having issues of sexual dysfunction, you can go to your physician, you know, go to your nurse practitioner and talk about, you know, how that's affecting you personally, but also your relationship. So bringing your spouse, your partner into that conversation with your physician could be really helpful. And again, you know, communication, and really trying to decrease that stigma, looking at it as just any other physical health issue, I think will be important in helping people to really be comfortable around it and addressing it.
Okay. Now, your spouse has served in the National Guard, mm-hmm. and I understand that there might be some particular challenges for those who have served in the National Guard and their families related to these issues. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. As with other mental health issues, National Guard members, if they're deployed, they come back to their communities. So the family members and the service member don't have an installation or a base nearby for support. So usually people around you don't know, you know, that you're a National Guard family, that your spouse may have deployed. So there's a little bit of feeling of isolation that could happen for our Guard families because they fall, you know, between the cracks, so to speak. They come back from a deployment, they go back to their life. And it's not, we all know that that's not that easy, transitioning from, you know, being in a war zone, coming back home and just going back to your job at Home Depot as a manager or something, right. It's not easy. And so trying to find, you know, ways in which we can reach out more to those families, and that would include all types of, you know, mental health issues, including sexual health problems, because dealing with PTSD, coming back from a deployment, they might not realize that this is a side effect, you know, that they might not understand that sexual functioning is going to be affected because they have PTSD or because they have depression or because they've been given an SSRI for that, like Zoloft or Prozac or a medication like that. They don't know that one of the side effects might be problems with sexual functioning. And that could actually, it's cyclical, it could actually increase, you know, their symptoms of depression and make it a lot harder for them. And it kind of snowballs from there. So there could be a lot of, you know, issues with it in their partnership, with their family. And again, particularly for National Guard, when they don't have that safety net around them, right, of a base, with all the resources that come with that and other families around you that understand, it could be really detrimental. So it's really key, no matter who you are, whether you're Guard, Reserve, Coast Guard, Navy, Marines, doesn't matter who you are, if you need to talk about these issues, you need to get help around it, because it could really save a life.
That's very important advice. If I could ask you one more question. Mm-hmm. Today's discussion focused on a lot of the veteran services organizations, mental health organizations like NAMI, other public health organizations, and what we might be able to do going forward, mm-hmm, to really improve services and supports to veterans and their families. What do you think some of those key areas are that we can all work together on?
I think, first of all, education. We need to get it out there that this is an issue. There's such a stigma around it that no one talks about it, ever. It's kind of not on the radar. In general, it is when you're talking about reproduction, you know, and you know, fertility issues, but not this specifically. So education, getting it out there, decreasing the stigma, mm-hmm, making sure that, you know, people are comfortable talking about it, and that comes from the top down. So, you know, if possible, having leaders talk about not just PTSD and suicide and depression and anxiety, but also, you know, that there are these side effects that you might struggle with sexual issues, and that it's normal, and that you can get treatment for it. And then the third piece of it is actually, you know, providing the resources and, connecting them with help. So that's really what we talked about today, which was so key. All of these organizations that care about our veterans and our service members coming together to try and find solutions. Because again, this is a problem that can add to other problems, mm-hmm, significantly. With mental health issues could be seriously impacted. People could become much more depressed if they can't function sexually with their partner. This is important.
Great. Well, Dr. Herrera-Yee, thank you so much for coming down to participate in the dialogue today, and thanks for taking the time to speak with me too.
Sure, thank you. Okay.